Hello students, hope you all are fine. So in today's class, I am going to explain the chapter, How Far is the River? It is written by Ruskin Bond. Well, before I start this chapter, I would like to ask one question. Do you love rivers? Do you want to see rivers? Everybody wants. Sabko nadiyan achhi lagti hain. Nature achha lagta hai. Right? And you know, beta, it is with everyone. All of us have a natural curiosity about nature and their surroundings. It is natural for us to want to see all whatever we read or hear about. Okay, so in this story, we will learn about a boy who has set his heart on going to the river on the other side of the mountain. Nadi jo hoti hai, wo bahut dur hoti hai, but he had decided that he had to see the river, and then he goes to see that river. Okay, before I explain the chapter, let us know something about the writer Ruskin Bond. Ruskin Bond is an Indian author who was born on 19th May 1934. His father was with the Royal Air Force, and Mr. Bond, he spent most of his childhood in Dehradun, where he stayed with his grandmother. You know, he wrote his first short story, Untouchable, in 1950, and at that time he was just 16 years old. Dekho kitna kam umar mein he had started his writing work. Not only this, he was awarded the Padma Shri in 1999 and also Padma Bhushan in 2014. Alright, so let us come back to the story. How Far is the River? Written by Ruskin Bond, where he tells us about the curiosity of his small child to visit a river. You know, there was a boy of about 12 years. He was sturdy, with untidy hair and black eyes. He liked walking barefoot. Usko nange paon chalna bahut achha lagta tha. Okay, so in this story, hum wahi padhne ja rahe hain. A young boy sets his heart on going to the river on the other side of the mountain. Does he get there? Okay, we'll find the answer of these two lines in the story. Section 1. Between the boy and the river stood a mountain. The boy was young, the river was small, and the mountain was big. The thickly forested mountain hid the river, but the boy knew it was there, where it was and what it looked like. He had never seen the river with his own eyes, but from the villagers he had heard of it, of the fish in its waters, of its rocks and currents and waterfalls, and it only remained for him to touch the water and know it personally. The beautiful lines these are. You know what? What is there? The boy, he was 12 years old and he wanted to see the river. Okay, beta. But there was one thing. The place where the boy lived, okay, and where the river was, between them, there was a big mountain, tall mountain. And boy was very young. River choti si thi, aur jo pahar tha, wo bahut bada tha. Thickly forested mountain. Thickly forested मतलब mountains के ऊपर तो जंगल होते हैं पूरे के पूरे, है ना, बहुत सारे trees. Thickly मतलब बहुत घने जंगल थे वहाँ पर. And they hid the river. जो mountain के ऊपर बड़े बड़े पेड़ थे, जिसकी वजह से नदी यहाँ से दिखाई नहीं देती थी. But the boy knew it very well. उसको पता था कि how it looked like, because उसने कभी अपनी आंखों से नहीं देखा था. He had never seen it with his own eyes, but he had heard from someone. The villagers had told कि there were fish in the water and waterfalls हैं वहाँ पे, currents of water का flow है beautifully. तो he had heard about the river's beauty and it only remained. जब लोगों ने उसको बताया river के बारे में कि वो ऐसी लगती है, ऐसा लगता है, you know, only one thing was left कि उसको सिर्फ touch करना था. मतलब he had the image of the place and the river in his mind after hearing from the people. When the people told him different things about the place, the river, so he had made one image. ऐसा होता है ना कि आपके दिमाग में कोई अच्छी सी image बन जाती है किसी चीज़ को सुनने के बाद, तो आपको लगता है जैसे आपने उसको देख लिया. बस वही बात जो थी इस बच्चे के साथ भी थी. He just wanted to touch it personally, मतलब खुद जाकर के उसको फिजिकली टच करना चाहता था और देखना चाहता था. ही वॉज सो मच क्यूरियस फॉर डैट. नाउ ही स्टूड इन फ्रंट ऑफ हिज हाउस ऑन द हिल अपोजिट द माउंटेन एंड गेज्ड अक्रॉस द वैली. dreaming of the river. He was about 12 years old, a sturdy boy. Sturdy means strong. ठीक है, strong boy, firm, with untidy. Untidy means dirty, not neat. मतलब बालों को अच्छे से, उसके बाल जो थे बहुत ही नीट नहीं थे. And black hair and shining black eyes. He had fine features and clear brown skin. But his hands and feet were rough and scratched. Scratched का मतलब क्या होता है? जैसे कहीं कहीं पर चोट लग जाती है ना, a slight wound, mark. यहाँ वहाँ कुछ कुछ marks थे चोट के. He was barefooted. Barefooted मतलब without any shoe or chappal. He was not wearing anything in the feet. वो बिल्कुल नंगे पाँव चलना उसको अच्छा लगता था. Right बेटा? Hope it is clear. This much chapter. Now, the thing is that he was barefooted means इसका मतलब ये नहीं था कि he was not able to afford. Afford मतलब to get shoes. ऐसा नहीं था कि वो उसके लिए पैसे spend नहीं कर सकता था या shoes buy नहीं कर सकता था. This was not the thing. बल्कि he liked the feel of warm stones and cool grass. उसको अच्छा लगता था गरम गरम पत्थरों पे चलना या ठंडी घास पर चलना. मीन्स नेचर को फील करना उसको अच्छा लगता था. ऑलराइट, वो नेचर के हर फॉर्म को एक्सेप्ट करता था. उसको पसंद था कि चाहे वो गर्मी हो चाहे ठंडी घास हो. ही लव्ड डेट. एंड इसका एक और रीज़न भी था, नॉट वेयरिंग शूज सेव्ड हिम द ट्रबल ऑफ टेकिंग देम ऑफ. मतलब अगर वो पहन के भी चलता शूज़ को तो उसको नेचर की ब्यूटी, नेचर की फीलिंग इतनी पसंद थी कि उसको शूज़ निकालने पड़ते. तो इसलिए इस ट्रबल से भी वो बच जाया करता था कि टेकिंग ऑफ शूज़, शूज़ को निकालने की ज़रूरत ही नहीं पड़ती थी. ही डिडेंट वेयर शूज़. Okay, so it was 11 o'clock and he knew his parents wouldn't be home till evening. So one day he got a chance, his parents were not at home. One day he got a chance, his parents went out of the village, leaving the boy alone at home. Okay, so what happened then? Here was a loaf of bread he could take with him, and on the way he might find some fruit. Here was the opportunity he had waited for. Now he had got a chance. कि आज parents नहीं है. Opportunity क्या होता है? Chance, मौका मिल गया था. It would not come again for a long time because it was not very often. His mother and father visited relatives for the entire day and left him on his own. क्योंकि ऐसा generally हुआ नहीं करता था कि parents पूरा दिन घर से चले जाएं और उसको अकेला छोड़ के चले जाएं. So now he found an opportunity in it. To realize his dream of visiting the river. Kyunki visiting the river was his dream. And then what happened? They had gone out on something important. Parents ko koi urgent kaam tha. And that is why they had left sketchy meal for him. Sketchy means not proper meal. Incomplete meal jo sufficient nahi tha. Usme kya kya tha? A loaf of bread, some milk and two eggs. The boy put the loaf of bread in a newspaper and set out on his journey. Now, the journey was not an easy one. The path to the river dropped steeply into the valley and then rose and went around the big mountain. Okay, it was frequently used by the villagers, the woodcutters, milkmen, mule drivers, but there were no villages beyond the mountain or near the river. He had started his journey, लेकिन उसको पता था जो वो रिवर तक जाने का रास्ता था वो वैली में से होके जाता था और माउंटेन के चारों तरफ घूमता हुआ जाता था. लेकिन माउंटेन के पास और रिवर के पास there were no villages. Now what happened? The boy moved on and after some time he met a woodcutter. And the woodcutter was a short man, a powerful man, but he had a creased and weathered face. Creased and weathered मतलब wrinkled face. And muscles that stood out in hard, ugly lumps. With age, jo skin ki age thi, swellings thi, and face was wrinkled. Section 2. The boy met the woodcutter and inquired with him how far the river was. The woodcutter replied that it was away by 7 miles. Ki 7 miles abhi dur hai. He also warned the boy that it might be difficult to return before evening. But the boy didn't listen to him. He said, I am a good walker. The woodcutter warned him, ki you are going to the river, okay, but it is very far. But the boy started his journey again and the woodcutter looked after him with some misgivings and decided to keep an eye out for the boy on his way back from the market. Aur wo jahan khada tha bazaar se, peeche se us bacche ko dekhta hi reh gaya. with some misgivings. What is the meaning of misgivings? जैसे उसको लग रहा था, he had some doubts कि something bad might happen. कहीं कुछ बुरा ना हो जाए इस बच्चे के साथ, ये कहाँ जा रहा है? Well, now the path was steep and the boy had to run most of the time. It was a dizzy, winding path. Dizzy क्या होता है? जैसे feeling as if everything is turning around. जैसे आप कभी ट्रेन में चलते हो या बहुत ऊंचाई से अगर आप नीचे की तरफ देखते हो तो आपको लगता है ना आपका सिर गोल गोल घूम रहा है. The same feeling the boy was having, क्योंकि जो रास्ता था it was winding. Winding मतलब with bends and curves. पूरा घुमावदार रास्ता था पहाड़ों के बीच में. And the boy was moving on that. उसको लग रहा था कि उसको चक्कर भी आ रहे हैं. And he slipped once or twice and slid into a bush or off. Slid मतलब वो फिसल भी गया एक दो बार, but still he was a person of determination, willpower, कि मुझको तो नदी देखनी ही है. The hill was covered with lush green ferns, evergreen, small small plants, पूरे के पूरे वहाँ आसपास he could see. और वहाँ पे creepers थे. Creepers are the plants which need some support, है ना? They cannot stand straight. They have very weak stem. All right. And a great wild dahlia. Dahlia तो flowering plant है. आपको आजकल winter के सीजन में dahlia के आप देखना flowers, बड़े बड़े big big flowers सबके घरों में मिल सकते हैं आपको. You can see. Would suddenly rear its golden head from the leaves and ferns. And now rear का मतलब rays. वहाँ पर ferns थे आसपास, leaves थी और उनके बीच में से कहीं कहीं पर उसको flowers दिख रहे थे, dahlia के flowers. Now what happened? The boy continued his journey and he was in the valley. He saw a girl who was coming from the opposite direction. She held a long curved knife with which she had been cutting grass. Okay, that girl, she was cutting grass. And now what happened? This boy, he asked the girl, how far is the river? The girl had obviously never been to the river. Obviously मतलब clearly लग रहा था उससे बातें करके कि वो कभी नदी के पास नहीं गई है. She may have been thinking of another one because she said 20 miles without any hesitation. Without any hesitation मतलब no confusion, no stammering, बिना हिचकिचाए, बिना कुछ सोचे उसने बोल दिया, हाँ 20 miles away है. The boy laughed and ran down the path. A parrot suddenly screeched. Parrot की आवाज़ उसको सुनाई दी. Flew low over his head. A flash of red and green. उसके ऊपर से एक पैरेट बहुत तेज उड़ता हुआ निकल गया. It took the course of the path and the boy followed its dipping flight, running until the path rose and the bird disappeared amongst the trees. जब उसको एक पैरेट जाता हुआ दिखा तो उसको लगा बर्ड्स वगैरह कहाँ जाते हैं? ग्रीनरी के आसपास जाते हैं, कहीं आसपास ट्री होगी, रिवर होगा, पानी होगा. He got one idea and he followed that flight of the bird and soon the bird it disappeared amongst the trees. A trickle of water came from the hillside and the boy stopped to drink. Now he was thirsty also. He saw a slow thin flow of water. Trickle of water का मतलब क्या होता है? आपने देखा होगा ना पहाड़ों में से कहीं से एक पतली सी धार निकल रही होती है पानी की, तो thin flow of water he saw and he stopped to drink water. The water was very cold and refreshing. Now what happened? The sun was striking his side of the hill, means it was shining on his head and it became hotter, the stones scorching the boy's feet. Scorching ka matlab uske pair jalne lag gaye the. It was too much hot that time and he was sure he had gone halfway. He continued his journey. Now section 3. Presently he saw another boy ahead of him. Presently means soon. Now he met one boy who was a shepherd. Shepherd means चरवाहा, जो भेड़ों को चराते हैं, ठीक है ना? He was driving a few sheep down the path. Now, this boy asked that shepherd, how far is the river? The village boy smiled in a friendly way and said, oh, not far, just around the next hill and straight down. बस पास में ही है, अब तो ज़्यादा दूर है ही नहीं. The boy felt hungry and shared his loaf of bread with the shepherd boy. अब दोनों ने मिलकर के वहाँ बैठ करके खाना खाया. When they had finished, they walked on together and began talking. आपस में बातें करने लग गए. The boy didn't notice the smarting of his feet. Smarting means pain. The pain he was having in his feet. बहुत देर से वो नंगे पांव चल रहा था, है? And then even heat of the sun, he didn't realize. He forgot the distance he had covered and the distance he had yet to cover. क्योंकि when you have company of somebody else na, then you forget all the pains. And both were busy, they were engaged in talking, and the point came where both had to diverge. Diverge means to take other ways. The shepherd had to go to some other way and this boy had to go to the different way, and both went on. After walking for some more time, the boy He looked up and down the mountain path. He couldn't see anyone. His own house was not visible. No sight, nothing. He began to feel discouraged. क्योंकि if somebody had been with him, he wouldn't have faltered. Faltered का मतलब उसको वो discouraged feel नहीं करता, वो अकेलापन feel नहीं करता. लेकिन क्योंकि वो अकेला जा रहा था, he was very much tired and he was really sorry he had finished the food. उसे इस बात का दुख भी था कि अब उसके पास खाने के लिए कुछ नहीं बचा है, because whatever he had shared with that shepherd boy. He felt discouraged as the river was not yet in sight. But he came more than halfway and could not go back. अब उसको ये भी नहीं था कि वो वापस भी घर जा नहीं सकता था और आगे उसको रिवर भी दिखाई नहीं दे रही थी. He was not getting any idea that how far was the river. और उसको एक चिंता और भी थी कि अगर वो फेल हो गया तब उसको बहुत शर्म आएगी कि जो उसका एक्सपीरियंस था वो अच्छा नहीं रहा, सक्सेसफुल नहीं रहा. He wanted to reach the river also. So, with much determination, he started his journey. He continued his journey. He walked on along the hot, dusty, stony path. There were no fields, no huts, only forest, sun and loneliness. सिर्फ उसको क्या दिखाई दे रहा था? Sun की brightness, sun चमक रहा था, जंगल ही जंगल थे और कुछ नहीं था. He could see only trees and rocks and bramble and flowers, only silence. Bramble मतलब thorny bushes, झाड़ियाँ जिसपे कांटे लगे हुए होते हैं. And then these were the only things he could see around him. After walking for some more time in impressive silence, he went round a sharp bend. अब अचानक से क्या हुआ? उसको वहाँ पे बिल्कुल साइलेंस दिख रहा था, कुछ भी नहीं था. लेकिन ये साइलेंस वो साइलेंस नहीं था जब वो अकेले में घर में महसूस करता था. This was the silence of space of the unknown. एक ऐसी जगह पर जहाँ कुछ भी उसका जाना पहचाना नहीं है, उस साइलेंस को वो फील कर पा रहा था. But there wasn't any movement either except for the bending of grass beneath the boy's feet. Beneath means नीचे, पाँव के नीचे वो घास को फील कर रहा था जब वो चल रहा था. ग्रास जो थी वो हल्की सी झुक रही थी, पैरों के नीचे दब जाती है ना. और the circling of a hawk high above the pine trees. Big pine trees के आसपास birds were circling. Pine के trees के आसपास. Then as the boy rounded a sharp bend, when he just turned, what happened? The silence broke into sound. और जो वो खामोशी थी वो एकदम sound में change हो गई. And he found the river tumbling over rocks far down the valley. Just see, a sudden roaring sound, the sound of the river. Far down the valley, the river tumbled over rocks fast and frenzied. Frenzied मतलब which cannot be controlled by anyone. इतनी तेज water का flow था. And the boy was excited to see the river. He ran down and entered the river. He felt the coldness of the mountain water. He felt very happy as his dream came true. Okay, he was ankle deep in the painfully cold mountain water. उसको इतना अच्छा लग रहा था पानी के अंदर. And the water was blue and white and wonderful. Beauty of the nature has been described. Just see, the boy who was full of determination, who wanted to see the river, now was able to touch the water of the river. है ना, nice story. है ना, story का मतलब सिर्फ story नहीं होता बेटा, it conveys a message. Now the message of the story: to achieve something we need to dream about it first. यदि आपको life में कुछ चाहिए तो पहले आपको dreams रखने चाहिए अपने high. Always think big, तभी आप life में कुछ achieve कर सकते हो. Okay, now in this story, just see, a boy of 12 years, how he was full of determination. His willpower was so strong. He was keen ki I have to go to see the river. And he was able to do that. So moral of the story, it revolves around the idea of overcoming the obstacles that come in the way of achieving one's dream. The story tells you that there will be risks needed to be taken in order to achieve your dreams. There will be people to discourage you and send you back or to give you wrong information. Okay, there would be companions, your friends will be there who will always discourage you. They will try to discourage you, but never look back. आपको हमेशा कहाँ फोकस करना चाहिए? अपने गोल के ऊपर. यू नीड टू वर्क हार्ड, यू शुड ओवरकम ऑल द प्रॉब्लम्स, फोकस ऑन योर गोल एंड यू विल डेफिनेटली अचीव इट. सो दिस इज द बेस्ट मैसेज यू गेट फ्रॉम दिस स्टोरी कि डिटर्मिनेशन जरूर होना चाहिए. लेकिन वन मोर थिंग, इट शुड नेवर बी ओवरलुक्ड. मीन्स एक चीज को हमें कभी नहीं भूलना चाहिए कि दिस स्टोरी इट डिस्क्राइब्स हाउ यंगस्टर्स डू थिंग्स विदाउट टेलिंग देयर पेरेंट्स. दिस इज वेरी बैड. हालांकि दिस थिंग वर्कड वेल फॉर द बॉय बट मे नॉट बी सिमिलर इन केस ऑफ एवरी पर्सन. वो बच्चा बिना अपने पेरेंट्स को बताए हुए चला गया इतनी दूर. चलो डेट पर्सन वॉज लक्की, डेट बॉय वॉज लक्की, ही वॉज एबल टू डू डैट. लेकिन हर पर्सन तो लक्की नहीं हो सकता ना. सो द पाथ बींग अननोन, द स्लोप बींग स्टीप एंड द रिवर बींग डेंजरस, रोरिंग एंड रशिंग, एनीथिंग कुड हैव हैपन टू द बॉय. है ना, डेट बॉय वॉज फॉर अवे, इट वॉज नॉट इन द नॉलेज ऑफ द पेरेंट्स. तो ये कुछ भी हो सकता था ना उस बच्चे को. तो दिस मैसेज यू ऑल्सो गेट कि कभी भी कुछ भी ऐसा काम नहीं करना चाहिए विच यू डोंट टेल टू योर पेरेंट्स. आपको किसी को बताकर ही जाना चाहिए. ओके, सो जस्ट कीप द मैसेजेस और द थीम्स और द मॉरल्स वट एवर यू गेट फ्रॉम द स्टोरीज ऑलवेज इन योर माइंड, पॉजिटिव एंड नेगेटिव बोथ द साइड्स वी शुड थिंक. Hope the chapter is clear. That's all about this chapter. Let us discuss about the questions which can be. What stood between the boy and the river? A mountain stood between the boy and the river. Why was the boy barefoot? The boy was barefoot because he felt free in his bare feet. He wanted to feel the heat of the stones and he wanted to feel the cool grass. What meal did his parents leave for him? They left a loaf of bread, milk and 2 eggs. According to the village girl, how far was the river? According to the girl, the river was 20 miles away. And what did the village boy say? The village boy said that the river was not far away, just around the next hill and then straight down. Okay, the river was far, but the boy reached it. What does this tell you about the boy? The boy reached the river even though it was far away and quite a difficult walk it was. He made the journey all by himself. This tells us that he was determined, strong and brave. The boy didn't notice the smarting of his feet and the heat of the sun. Why do you think the boy didn't feel any pain or the heat of the sun? Because he had the company of the village boy, the boy didn't feel any pain or the heat of the sun. He was very much busy talking with the boy. Okay, and so he forgot all his pains for some time. That's all in this chapter, children. Hope it is clear. In case of any doubts, please feel free to ask in the comment box. Okay, if you liked it, please like, share and subscribe. Thank you.